Mike the True Jackson with the CageDoor.net. I'm here with Angel Huerta. Man, awesome fight. Tell us about it.
I guess I don't know if it was pressure, man. I know I got a lot of expectations after my last two fights, man. And I know a lot of people want to see me do well. And a lot of people believe in me. It's kind of hard to ignore that stuff, you know. And I want to say that, you know, it's something that I can block out, but it's a little hard, man. You know, a lot of people see potential in me, man, and I do too. And I don't want to let anybody down. And I don't know if it was nerves or the weight cut or something, but after, in that first round, I got a little tired, I got a little winded. Andy came to fight. I knew he was gonna be fighting, and he was a lot tougher than I knew people thought. And he was crafty, man. He took a couple good shots and kept coming forward. And he took the fight on a short notice, man. So big ups to him for taking the fight.
Definitely, man. It seemed like in the first round you came out ready to go. We saw some spinning back kicks. We saw that karate background, man.
I tried it, man.
When you said you got tired, was that after he seemed like he took you down?
I stayed relaxed. They actually let me catch my breath. I was able to just relax and just kind of hold him without getting hit. You know, just kind of working on my defense from the guard. And I worked that a lot with Draculino and stuff. And he was in my side. I ended up getting to full guard and stuff. And then I think we got back up. You know, it was the end of the round, and I ended up on top of him and I was hitting him. So, you know, what was the question?
Let's talk about the second round, which actually, anybody know my background in boxing, the footwork, the jab, man, I told Bear, like, man, you look like Mike Jackson out there, going out there, man.
You know, the jab is the most underused weapon in MMA, like they say. The jab works on certain guys, you know, guys that like to kick a lot. I mean, a good counter for a jab, I think, is an inside leg kick. Or, kicking that front leg when they're about to step with the jab. And I noticed he wasn't really throwing it, so I kept popping the jab, just keeping him at bay and trying to set up my right hand. But he was covering up really good. So then I threw a couple of body shots when he covered up here, tried to hit him to the body.
Those definitely got in, too.
You think they got in? Yeah, so, you know, just continue to work, man, and grow my MMA game and try not to let the expectations really get to me and just let it push me to continue to work harder. And I'm glad the fight went 3 rounds. Was that three?
3 rounds.
It was good to get 3 rounds under my belt. I mean, if I can get it over with in the first round, that'd be awesome. But I don't really look for that. And getting pushed into the third round is definitely what I needed. You know, maybe not what I wanted, but what I needed. So the next time I know what it feels like, and I'll be prepared to go three threes really hard, you know, next time.
Yeah, well, so what's next for you?
It's up to Mick, man, really. I just want to keep fighting harder opponents. You know, I was scheduled to fight Nate. I think he's 3-3. He's got 6 pro fights. I don't know if we can make that happen again. And I just want to fight guys with more fights, more experience, and continue to make my way up the MMA ladder. And, no title fights or anything like that. They got some tough dudes at 135, like Steve Garcia. You know, a lot of people want to see that already. And I give them the most props, man. I don't think I'm ready for that, especially after today. So, I'd say a good year, maybe. If I continue to win and continue to grow, you know, maybe fight for a title. You know, who knows?
But
one thing's for sure, man, I'm going to keep training hard. And, it's like I said, if my people want to see me fight, man, I'll fight. So
cool. Vacation congratulations on their
vacation time first.
What's that?
Vacation time first.
Nah, man. Cool. I've taken enough vacations, man. My friends want to go to Miami for the Winter Music Conference in late March, and I think I'm not going to be able to do that because I want to continue to fight, man. I've partied enough in my 20s. Right now, my 30s is going to be all about
grinding
and getting on my MMA. And continue to learn, continue to grow, working with my people, man, and just trying to take it to that next level, man.
Cool, man. Congratulations.
Appreciate it.